This sugar isn't burning very well. Let's give it some powder power. So what we're doing here in this demonstration is puffing up some powdered carbohydrate powder over a candle flame inside the coffee tin. I prefer to use icing sugar, although you can use a whole range of different carbohydrates or even like a podium powder. When you use sugar, obviously you get that nice smell afterwards that fills the room, and so that's why I choose that one. Kleeps recommend using a coffee tin up to a maximum of about 750 grams with a soft lid like one of these. It's good to keep a selection of spare lids if you can, because over time you may find that they soften and you need a good seal in order for the demonstration to work well. It's worth noting that catering tins of powder come in different sizes, and this hot chocolate tin was actually a kilogram. Although the lid fits perfectly onto coffee tins, you should not use the base of this type of tin, as the candle inside will quickly melt through the lid. You need something a little bit taller. Getting the powder dry and finely distributed will really help your success with this demonstration. You can leave the powder in an oven at 80 Celsius, and I always recommend sieving to break up any lumps. Kleeps recommend threading a tube through a rubber stopper and using the stopper to hold yourself against the side of the coffee tin. Now, technically, you could just feed the tube directly into the base of the coffee tin, but the more pieces that can move during the demonstration, the less reliable it will be in front of the class. So I've sort of made a little attachment here which bends onto the bottom and makes sure that the puff of air is delivered to the base of the powder. A spoon is invaluable to load the powder over the end of the tubing inside the tin, and if you miss, it can be used to shape the powder pile. A pipe like this to deliver the powder makes things even easier. Clearly, the objective is to get the powder distributed over the candle. I keep a number of spares to hand just in case the candle gets gunked up by sugar. Let's talk orientation. You could use a little funnel inside and load that up with some sugar so that the powder is puffed upwards. Some variations on this show the tube being delivered to the opposite side of the tin and then blasting the sort of powder backwards towards the candle. When these setups explode, you definitely will get a louder and a bigger flame, but I find that this setup is also a little bit less reliable in front of a class. So the way I set up my tin is to leave the end of the pipe on the base of the tin. If you imagine that this is the base, obviously it's tricky to see inside the coffee pot when I've got it set up. Here I now have my tube set down at the base, and I'm going to cover that with my sugar, and then I'm going to leave my candle slightly downwind of the puffing air. Maybe sometimes actually slightly off to the side so that I'm not risking actually blowing out the candle with the puff of the air as it comes through. The tubing should be thin enough, a few millimeters internal diameter, so that you won't get any blowback. And you should not puff the sugar by mouth or invite students to perform this demonstration. There are short-term exposure limits to breathing the dusts that will definitely be exceeded this way. Kleeps recommend the use of a pipette bulb for puffing the powder. One thing I've also always had to hand in any school with a post-16 chemistry course is a balloon pump. And that often comes with the modelling balloons that you might use for teaching VSEPR. And if you're in a school that is using pipette bulbs, i.e. doing titrations, you probably also may have some modelling balloons and therefore may have one of these pumps around as well. Dim the lights and set up safety screens in front of and behind the apparatus to ensure that the lid can only escape vertically. Fit the lid on top and give it a puff. You can usually get a few blasts out of the same pile of powder. Having that spoon to hand allows you to reform the pile over the end of the tube. Cleanup is fairly self-explanatory. The only thing that you need to be careful of is raising dust as you pour the excess powder out into the bin. This is a demonstration that I've done since my first year of teaching, and at times I have been frustrated by failure, and I hope that some of the tips that I've given here might help you deliver this demonstration more reliably. If that's the case, do let me know. Thanks very much.